3 months is a long time if you don't like it where you are. 3 months is forever when the sun don't shine at all. You may be alive, but you just breathe to pass the time. But you're so lucky to have it all.
So Avinash, what happened that led to those events on that fateful day?
Hi, I'm Avinash. It so happened that day that I lost my job. You know, I've done my B.Tech from IIT Bombay and CSE. Then I did my MBA from IIT Ahmedabad. I was the best student in the whole campus, you know. Got placed into one of the best companies. Then, you know, it's in my nature to be successful. I often wonder how stupid people around me are. Like, they don't have intelligence, nothing, they just waste their life. It's just my bad luck that I have not achieved more. And that, on that fine day, I was waiting for my interview. I was so confident. Means like, I was the perfect candidate for the interview. So I went with full confidence that the job was secured, that the job was mine.
Everybody's looking at me, but I don't see them. Living for the weekend, caught in the deep end, trying to tread water. Do it for my humble daughter. Lambs in the slaughter, life's getting shorter. Trying to get high off of water. I'm flying a saucer, my life is a forecast. So I pop bottles, date top models. Middle finger in the air, not a care, going full throttle. Where's the love though? Nobody cares about that. Where's the club, where's the drugs though? Front row, follow the flow, mega upload. Feeling adrenaline rush, who's the mark though? I don't know. I'm caught in the rubble. Now pass me a shovel. Now pass me a shot and make it a double. I'm a whole shovel. It's all
on. A beggar came up to you, right? In the marketplace?
Yeah, the beggar. Don't remind me of him. He just touched me. Touched me. You mean like, compare our status. That guy's a downtrodden. I'm so well educated and you know I've achieved so much in life. How can he just come and touch me? There was so vague, like, I couldn't control my anger, I just pushed him out of my sight. That was really annoying. And then I advanced for giving my interview.
You took the interview of Avinash, right?
Yes, I conducted the interview. The interview was held in my company. So Avinash was a bright student. I was able to get it from his face. His face had that enthusiasm. Even though he was in his mid-40s, he showed interest for the job and I was able to get it. He was able to answer all my technical questions and I was pleased with his attitude. I asked him one question. While working in a team, which is more important? Is it your own intellect or is it hard work? He replied, both hard work and intellect are essential. But then he went on to say that for every person there is a spark. There is that spark which he said he had, which put him above the rest. And he said that this was what made him unique and he believed that he would rise to the top of the company. That made me really angry. How can this guy just come and tell that in just few years he could rise to the top position?
You rejected him.
So can you say that you're the managing director of the company, right? So you're also highly qualified. So can you say that you have never thought along those lines? That you have never considered yourself to be a cut above the others and have felt pride and ego in that fact?
These thoughts are natural to any human. Like, who wouldn't think about these things? But then, it's how you hide your inner personality while attending an interview or something. But while I attended my interview, I acted as if I knew everything that was there. But then I acted as if I wasn't overconfident. But Avinash was able to evidently convey the message that he was overconfident. He believed that he was a cut above the rest, and that this attitude of him, that he would rise above the rest and that no one was equal to him, made me instantly reject him. This made me tell, just go out, and I abruptly ended the interview.
So, after the interview ended, you came back to your apartment.
Yeah, came back to my apartment. I was just wondering what went wrong. How can I be rejected for a job? In the meantime, I heard a knocking in the door. So I went up. It was my landlady. She was asking for rent.
So you're the landlady of Avinash's building?
Yes.
So you knew Avinash for around 5 years, right?
Yeah. Avinash has been staying my building for around 5 years. He was a good tenant. He paid his rent on time. He was polite, although I felt that he had he was kind of proud about himself. But that was okay. Like, he was good. He seemed pretty hardworking. He went for work early in the morning and he came back late at night. But recently, I think he has had some problem. I went to his... I knew his mother was ill and I needed to collect the rent. So I went to his house to collect the rent. But then I just asked him about his job and he slammed the door on my face. I was so shocked. He had never been so rude. How could he be so rude that day? That too, these youngsters are there, no? They have no respect for elders.
After the check bounced, you came back to Avinash to again confront him about the fact that the check bounced and that his rent had not come through. You were aware of the fact that something was wrong with Avinash, that something had been bothering him. And even though you were the immediate guardian of Avinash, his landlady, why didn't you think it proper to probably hold off from the rent for a few days, probably give it some slack? Why was it so urgent to actually go and confront him that very day?
Well, yeah, because the check bounced back, I should have figured that he had some financial problem. But I need to pay my bills also. I'm an old lady. I'm 65 years old. I have diabetes. I need to take my own medicines. I have to take care of my own life. How can I go about bothering about every single person out there on the street, out there in my building? He's not my son. I'll take care of my life. I'm not bothered about his life. He has to pay his rent on time so that I can pay my bills on time.
So Avinash?
Yeah.
Your check bounced.
Yes.
Landlady again confronted you, and so you went to the bank.
Yeah, I went to the bank in a hope that I'll find a solution why my check bounced. And there I met one clerk who was my father's acquaintance. He knew me quite well. So we are having a happy conversation, and I just asked him why my check bounced. How could that be possible? Was there any fault in some signing or something like that?
So, you're the clerk in the bank.
Yeah.
You know Avinash from his childhood, right? You saw him grow up.
Yeah, he is a very bright and very smart guy. But the thing is, he is too proud of himself. I always thought that I should say something about this, but then, you know, why should I be the bad guy? And I didn't want to be, you know, the nosy guy who, like, messes up other people's lives.
So, you never considered it important to, like, tell Avinash about his faults or his mistakes? You let him, like, progress along whichever line he was going.
I always had this gut feeling that I should tell him, but then again, I'm not directly related to him, so why should I be the one to, like, tell him about what he's doing wrong?
So Avinash, your problem at the bank, you understood that your financial status was in really bad shape, and you came back to your apartment.
Yeah, I remember that day. I was very sad and depressed due to the events of that day. Then suddenly I got a call from doctor informing that my mother had passed away that very day. I was really shocked because she was the only one who understood me very well and knew that what I was capable of achieving. And she had left this world. This thought really was depressing, and I was completely mad. Why should I be in such a situation? I'm so successful, I'm so intelligent. There are many other people sitting in those higher posts who don't know anything else. Why should I be in such a situation, in such a bad financial situation where I lost my job, I lost my mother? Why should I be in such a situation? I really lost my mental stability, and I needed I got the feel that I should go to that interviewer and tell him that I deserve the job and he should be below me, and I am the best candidate and he doesn't deserve anything. So I started running out of my home to the interview spot to tell him what actually is correct.
I love you. I'm sorry, I wasn't good enough. Dear Father, forgive me. 'Cause in your eyes, I just never added up. In my heart, I know I failed you, but you left me here alone. If I could hold back the rain, would you numb the pain? 'Cause I remember everything. If I could help you forget, would you take my
duty that day? You saw Avinash coming, and what occurred to you when you first saw him approaching?
I saw a man who was heading towards me. He called my fellow mate to look around the situation. did you see?
He was running madly towards us. He was trying to go past me at our opposition.
We tried to resist him at first, but he was not that kind of a person who would, take those kind of resistance, so we started to beat him. He was risking us.
So, saw this man approaching, saw that he was not in a proper mental state, and he considered justified to actually assault him. Did you not think that it might be better to actually subdue him and then call for help and get him proper medical aid?
It was in the middle of the night and each and every one of us are quite irritated at that point of time. So we did our job, that was our job to do. That's what we had to do.
So you beat him up and then you dragged him over to the side of the road and you left him in that condition.
Yeah, I mean, that's what happens to a person who's behaving like that. So it's correct to do that actually. Why is it wrong? So a person who's heading towards you, you resist him, but he doesn't, you know, take that resistance. He beats you up or he pushes you. So we had to do that eventually.
Your job is security guards. To provide security.
Yeah,
did you think that you did justice to the job? You prevented an intruder from entering the building, but at what cost?
That doesn't affect us anyway. Our job is to just, you know, prevent him entering the building, so we did our job.
So Avinash, after the security guards dealt with you and you were left on the road, what happened?
I was so heartbroken and my body was aching, my legs and hands were completely broken and I was very sad and I was feeling the pain, the aching body. I was completely physically and mentally broken. So many people passed by, but nobody gave any attention to me. I was like literally shouting for help, but nobody turned up. I always felt that I was more comfortable with my group of people, like who are in my position, like middle class people and all. I never gave any attention to those who were downtrodden and all. I was so sad and I was crying for help. Actually, the interviewer whom I wished to tell, he also passed near me and I cried for help. But he didn't give care. He knew me well. He could have just taken me to some hospital or something. But he just didn't care. I don't know why.
So you saw Avinash lying on the road in that situation. Why didn't you step forward to help him?
It was late in the evening, a tiring day of work. I'd finished work and I left the office. I was walking down the lane. I saw this man who clung down to my feet. He was pulling my feet. I first looked at his face. I was startled. A beggar pulling my feet. I looked at his face for about a minute and realized that it was the same guy who had come to give the interview. I immediately shunned him and realized this is something that he deserved. He was the one who acted as if he knew everything and that attitude did not matter. He believed that it was his own achievements which would carry him forward in life, and that his attitude was of least concern for him. Once I realized that, I just started walking. I did not care.
But he was just another human being in need of medical help. Why didn't you, out of that empathy, just go out and help him?
I mean, why would I involve myself in such stupid things? That too late at night. I had to go home. I had to spend some time with my family. Taking Avinash to the hospital, then getting involved in some police cases. I mean, that's totally unnecessary and unwanted for. I mean, and I felt that he actually deserved it. It was something that he actually deserved it. I'd not like to even go near him and offer a helping hand. If it had been anyone else, I would have even approached them and asked what their problem was. But this guy was the same guy that pissed me off in the interview. So why would I approach him and help him? There was no necessity to do that.
Do you recall the beggar in the marketplace?
Yeah.
He was also in a situation that was way below yours at that time, and you shunned him away. So why did you expect people to show you empathy in such a situation?
You can't compare me to a beggar. And then a guy helped me up and cared and took care of me and provided me with some food and water. I madly ate and drank, and with a gratifying look, I wanted to greet him. Then I was shocked. It was the same beggar whom I had pushed away in the same morning before the interview. I was really shocked. How can this happen? Then I finally got the realization that our society is like this. All the middle class or upper class people, they don't care that much about the guys who are in a bad situation. But it is actually these downtrodden and beggars and all those, they actually help people who are in real need of help.